So a little bit more reading from the book Quantum Body, and I'm reading from one of the breakthroughs. The brain is not the mind. So I'll just read a paragraph and then I will do a little explanation. Some of it is in the book and some of it is not. So this chapter reads, "The brain is not the mind. Theories can be judged by what they leave out as much as by what they include, and the less they leave out, the better. A whopping amount is left out when any theory mistakes the brain for the mind. This is such a common assumption that for the vast majority of neuroscientists, brain equals mind. If you make this mistake, you will decide that sight is created by the visual cortex. There's no image in the visual cortex, just neural correlates. You will also make the mistake that smell is created by the olfactory bulb, and so on. Neural correlates are not the same thing as the experience. With a detailed brain map, so the thinking goes, neuroscience will be able to point to the exact clump of brain cells where every thought and sensation is created. The fatal flaw with this view is that the brain doesn't have any experiences. As I've mentioned before, you can take a knife and put it through the brain, and you won't even feel pain. The brain does not have any experiences. It merely transmits what the mind is experiencing. If you know algebra, does your brain know algebra? If you love chocolate, does your brain love chocolate? Does your brain get depressed, elated, anxious, or triumphant? The correct answer to all these questions is no. So why does medical science continue to assert that the brain is responsible for the mind? Okay, so this chapter goes on into great details, but just a little bit more. The brain contains ordinary atoms and molecules. Atoms and molecules don't think. The brain has no light or sound inside its gray, mushy tissues. There are no pictures or music in your brain, yet somehow you see pictures and hear music. Okay, this is of course called the heart problem, and it has no solution because it's made on the wrong assumption, which is that matter is the ontological primitive of the universe. The brain has no location for the self, the I we all identified with. There's no proof that the brain has experiences of any kind. It has only electrochemical activity. Why does this matter? This matters because you can change the neural networks of your brain by changing your mind. You don't say, "I change my brain," you say, "I change my mind." But in the deeper reality, both brain and mind are experiences in awareness. So the brain is part of what we call the physical body, and the mind is part of what we call the subtle body, mind, intellect, and ego. Physical body is called energy and matter, but they're both parallel and entangled activities of a deeper domain, which is awareness. And that is what we really mean when we say I. I is the non-changing factor in every changing experience. Mind changes, brain changes, but I remains eternally the silent witness. So, on a practical level, this is our sense of self. There's much more in the book, but I thought I'd give you a glimpse. The brain is not the mind, the mind is not the brain. They're entangled activities of a deeper domain, which is non-local, eternal, and timeless, and it is what we call I am. Let me know your feedback.